Oh, hello there. Just getting myself a delicious Dr. Steele beer. Mmm, that's tasty.
Wait, how do I know it's tasty? I haven't had it yet.
Hang on.
It's in here somewhere. There we go.
The key to my heart. Beer. Refreshing. Almost tastes like a Newcastle. Interesting. Actually, that's because it is a Newcastle. And if you'll bear with me for a few minutes while I edit the shit out of this video, I'll show you how to make your very own Dr. Steele brew. Here, let's improve the lighting a little bit, shall we? Ah, your very own Dr. Steele beer is a, let's see, Steele Brewery's limited lager slash ale. It's oh so tasty, I assure you. Good stuff. So I'm going to show you how to make one of these bad boys. And really the first step before even printing the label, first step is getting the old label out of the way. So for that, I use a big bowl full of water. The beer soaking in it so the label breaks down a little bit. Well, to pardon my dishes, I'm lazy, you see, the thing is, I don't like washing dishes. I like eating, so I make more dishes, but then I don't like washing the old ones. So, yeah, I'll just put that away. So, for this guy, it's been soaking for an hour and a half now, and the label is actually really easy to remove now. It just scrapes right off. Now, I found that doing this in the water is actually a lot easier, which is why I moved the bowl to the sink here, because I'm not really going to be careful about it. As I go, I'm just going to slosh water around, and if I didn't do it in the sink, it would make a big mess. So, there you go. Put the bowl in the sink. Pretty straightforward. The large label, you can try and peel it off all as one piece if you want, but it really isn't going to work right. You'll want to take your time and tear some strips out of it one at a time, little pieces like I'm doing here. If you try to take the whole label all at once, you're actually going to leave little pieces of it behind. Believe it or not, you leave more behind peeling it like that than you would as individual strips. And as you can see, there's plenty of glue left on here. And if you scrape at the glue, it just comes right off. So you can sit here and film me scraping the glue for a while, and I'll just fast forward through it.
Actually, I wasn't planning on putting sound over this, so we're gonna get that fucking, where's that? Ready, Sax. Your rendition of it, at least. Let's just get it fast forward. I wonder what it would sound like if I did it slow and then played it fast forward, so let's find out. We'll find out, yes. Almost done.
Squeaky clean. Well, still a Newcastle, still a delicious beer. It just doesn't advertise anymore, except for the cap. As far as the cap, I haven't really figured out anything to make a Dr. Steele cap, and I think it's only fair that Newcastle will get credit for their beer, because Newcastle is really a pretty good beer. So I'm just going to head back to my workshop and show you the label and how to fix it. So this is my workshop. Take a look around. Yep, full of crap. As you can see, I'm currently working on my Dr. Steele flag as well. This is my first run of it. During my second run, I'll go ahead and give you guys a tutorial for it. But for the time being, beer. Because, damn, it's good. So, here is our cleaned off bottle. And basically, you just print on regular paper Nothing special. And cut it out as closely as you can to the line. If anything, you want to cut into the printed area more. That way you don't have like a white border around your label once you put it on the bottle. But really pretty straightforward. Just take your time about it. Make sure your cuts are nice and smooth. You don't want a jagged edge to it. You want a nice curve to the edge.
Now, these are practically brand new scissors, so they have a really nice sharp edge to them. I highly recommend that whenever you're cutting anything out like this, you want to have really nice edges. Either new scissors, or you can actually take some scissors apart and resharpen them. Like Fisker's brand, you can actually take the scissors apart with a flathead screwdriver and sharpen them like you would with a regular knife, which is really kind of nice. It keeps you in a good, nice, sharp pair of scissors all the time. Now, these are just cheapo Westcott scissors. I bought them from Staples when they went on sale for $1. And they do the job quite nicely for $1. In any case, just cut out your label. And like I said, take your time about it. Make sure you do a good job. Nobody's really going to be likely to sit there and critique the edges and say, hey, you've got an odd spot right here, so it doesn't have to be perfect. Just nothing that's going to like jump out at somebody is obviously screwed up or defective or what have you.
And I'm just about done with this guy. A couple more cuts here should do it. And I'll show you how to apply your label properly, so that it's not just going to fall off as soon as somebody handles it, or fall off in the fridge while it's chilling. So, there's our label, and what I'm going to use is 3M Super 77 and a glue stick, which I lost my glue stick somehow. So, we'll go to my random craft cabinet and pull out a glue stick. Random craft cabinet, full of random crap and board games to get my glue stick. Now, the glue stick is not going to hold the label to glass. It won't work. You can put as much of it on there as you want, but on the glass, when you put it in the fridge and it cools down, the glue is actually going to release from the glass and your label is just going to fall off right there in the fridge. And it's probably going to make a big mess, especially if the label ends sticky side down in the fridge and screws up your shelf. So we're not going to use that. But what I do need is just some random scrap piece of paper. Oh, that'll do. Actual full sheets. Screwed up a print on. Just something to put in the back of it so that when you spray your Super 77, you don't blast over spray all over your hand or all over the floor or whatever. But really, you just want to get this center section, and it just takes a couple of quick little sprays. Nothing crazy. And then we're done with the Super 77. And this is actually the hard part, is making sure you line up the label properly so that when it wraps around the back, the two ends actually meet. So, just kind of picture in your head a plus sign and make the bottle the vertical on the plus sign. And the extensions they're going to wrap around are going to be the other ones. And, darn, I missed. See if I can adjust a little bit. Now this glue, you have to work pretty quick with it. If you take too long, it's just not going to stick anymore. It's going to lose all of its tackiness. There we go, that's a little better. And just like cutting it, this also does not really have to be perfect. It just has to kind of do the job. So then we take our glue stick, and with the glue stick, just kind of get one of the edges, roll it in, nice and snug, stick it down to the other piece of paper. Now the glue stick isn't going to hold paper to the glass, but it will hold the paper to the paper. So, as long as you get that good edge nice and stuck on there, should be set. Now all that remains is to chill and serve. So, to the fridge. Couple hours and that guy will be ready to drink. So there you have it, how to make a Dr. Steele beer. No brewing required.